Get your backside, trackside.
The Royal Darwin Show, usually a chance to get up close and personal with the local best in show. But this year, producers are on edge.
You know, if anything gets out up here, the whole industry is shut down overnight. With the number of wild pigs in the Northern Territory.
No grand parade, instead animals separated from spectators, with extra measures to try and stop the foot and mouth disease free industry walking into a multi-billion dollar threat. Already rampant in Indonesia, where producers like dairy farmer Kusnadi face mounting losses as animals succumb.
I have three cows that died, and I was forced to sell the other seven cows at a low price.
In Bali's Karang Asem district, attempts are being made to vaccinate, failing to keep pace with the spread.
It just continually circulates in the country. It just slows the meat production, the milk production, the wool production. So it's a real sort of economic disease.
I think it's important that we support Indonesia during this period. Indonesia is one of our largest trading partners, and their offence is going to be our best defence.
The opposition's been briefed about the Indonesia threat.
It's across 22 provinces and it's spreading like wildfire.
Well, we think from the advice that we got yesterday, which is very sobering, that this is not under control.
Labor calling for calm.
Scaremongering and fanning the flames of genuine concern does nothing to help our $80 billion agriculture industry stay strong.
Late this afternoon, Australia's Director of Biosecurity signed off on new powers to compel travellers returning from Indonesia to take extra precautions, in particular the use of sanitation footmats to try and remove any trace of the disease. But earlier calls from some within the opposition to close the border completely have been rejected.
The advice is that that is not necessary.
It would do nothing to actually address the other risks out there from other countries, particularly the other countries that have foot and mouth disease. Likewise, it would put at risk a trade that is very valuable.
Stepping carefully with economic and diplomatic risks to weigh up. Anna Henderson, SBS World News.